Plus, Christian pilgrimage aid receives boost as Pilgrims Commission expands scope of its operations. Welcome to this edition of NTA Network News with me, Muhammad Kudu Abubakar. President Muhammadu Buhari has challenged youths in the country as future leaders to embrace the Change Begins With Me campaign to make Nigeria great through the pursuit of knowledge, patriotic ideals and values that promote national aspirations. At an audience with some youth co-members serving in Daura, the president pledged his unalloyed commitment to the unity and prosperity of the country. Meanwhile, activities marking this year's Eid al-Kabir celebrations were rounded off in Daura, President Buhari's hometown, with a traditional concert put together by the paramount ruler of the emirate, Umar Farouk Umar. Details of these activities will be brought to you in our subsequent bulletins. The Nigerian military has been urged to sustain the tempo of its operations in the northeast to ensure the wiping out of the terrorism. Chief of Air Staff Air Marshal Sadiq Abubakar stated this during a special lunch with Nigerian Air Force troops in Maiduguri and Yola to mark the Salah celebration. Defense correspondent Isaac Onkuma reports.
These are not the regular faces of the Nigerian Air Force personnel. These are the young and gallant officers and men of 79 Composite Group Maiduguri from the trenches in the theater of war. But today is not a day for war. It is a day for merrymaking. It is Eid al-Kabir, the Feast of Sacrifice. This gathering, the Chief of Air Staff Air Marshal Sadiq Abubakar, who was represented, says is to appreciate the troops for the success recorded in the fight against insurgency in the northeast and acknowledge the supreme sacrifice made by their colleagues to keep the region and nation safe.
The good work which you are doing in the northeast is highly appreciated and commended by the President Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces. He appreciates your efforts in fighting the insurgency and urges you to sustain the operations to make the northeast in particular and Nigeria in general a better place to live.
Before leaving for Yola, the Chief of Air Staff inaugurated an aircraft shelter and inspected ongoing projects around the tarmac in the NAV base. At the Nigerian Air Force 75 Strike Group, Yola, the Chief of Air Staff assured the troops of their welfare and that of their families while commending their vigilance and quick response to assisting the ground troops in critical situations.
You have provided us with all the necessary facilities that will ensure our comfort and effective service delivery. We can only say thank you by giving full commitments to our duties. We therefore once again pledge our unwavering loyalty to the service of the Nigerian Air Force and the nation at large.
From the NAV base in Yola, Isaac Onkuma, NTA News.
In the spirit of Eid al-Kabir celebrations, children at the internally displaced persons camps in Borno State were brought together at a Salah party hosted by the wife of the state governor, Nana Shetima. Haman Jabani reports that the party appeared to have given the more than 200 children a sense of belonging.
The children numbering over 200 were drawn from various IDP camps in the metropolis to celebrate Salah at the seat of power in the state. The host, Nana Shetima, said the party was made possible due to the relative peace enjoyed in the state as a result of a commitment of President Muhammadu Buhari in the fight against insurgency in the northeast, most especially in Borno State. She said the Salah party for the children is to assure them of government support to their well-being, just as she called on them to attend school as their future leaders. Nana used the opportunity to commend SEMA chairman for the work he is doing to the IDPs in the state. Executive Chairman SEMA Satomi Ahmed commended the effort of Nana Shetima for organizing such party to the less privileged members of the society and called on well-meaning individuals to emulate her. Some of the children thanked Nana Shetima for hosting them and prayed for God to guide her and assured to go to school. There were lots to eat and drink for the children as well as dance and competition. In Maiduguri, Hammond Jabani, NTA News.
Still on the IDPs, the internally displaced persons in various camps in the Federal Capital Territory also observed the Eid al-Karu festival. Patient Gerald Christopher visited Durubi and Kuchigoro camps, from where she filed this report.
Although it was not celebration galore at Durumi Area 1 IDP camp, some internally displaced persons were seen in their sala clothes. The secretary of the camp, Bala Yusuf, said they are happy to witness the Eid al-Kabil and grateful for the gifts they received from some good-spirited Nigerians.
Actually, since we found ourselves here, we never see kind of conditions like this, because people are thinking like we are not an IDP in the Abuja. I'm praying that may God give this our president power, because we believe that he will work towards us, he will concern us as an IDP.
We are thanking for Almighty God that you have seen our own celebration of Salah time.
At the new Kuchigoro IDP camp, there was nothing to show that it was Salah. The IDPs were seen sitting in groups while others passed the time playing snooker game. They expressed displeasure over their situation.
Thank God we Salah is fine among us. We don't see any help.
You can see the place is so dry. We're supposed to experience some other things, but we did not even see anything.
Some FCT residents came to celebrate the Salah with the less privileged.
This particular Salah signifies love and sacrifice. I feel very fulfilled and I just want to come and show some love.
No matter how we are talking about the economy, we are still eating in our homes and we are still feeding our children. So what it means is that we should cut off the excesses we are having.
Despite the economic challenges in the country, the internally displaced persons are optimistic that peace and unity will reign in Nigeria. In Abuja, Patience Gayok Christopher, NTA News.
Still on the Salah, the Eid al-Kabir in Kefi and Nasarawa local government areas of Nasarawa State was conducted peacefully. Suraju Abdullahi reports that the Minister of State and Environment, Alhaji Ibrahim Usman Jibrin, urged Nigerians to support the Buhari administration, while the Emir of Kefi charged parents to immunize their children against polio.
The Imam of Kefi, Ustaz Abul Abdullahi, charged Muslims to use the lessons of sacrifice for nation building. The Imam of Nasarawa, Ustaz Muhammad Abdullahi, urged Muslims to uphold to the spirit of forgiveness as it breeds peaceful coexistence and sustainable development. The Minister of State Environment, Ibrahim Usman Jibril, called for understanding of the direction of the Buhari's administration as it is making effort to take the country to the promised land.
All these issues that we are facing will be a thing of the past, and I believe it is possible to turn around the economy if and when we give support to the government.
In his Salah message, the Emir of Kefi, Alhaji Shehu Chindoya Musa, called on parents to support the polio eradication campaign as the menace is rearing its ugly head again.
With the outbreak in Maiduguri, I will call on the people of Kefi, the state and the nation in general, to give cooperation so that this thing will go once and for all.
It was a hate-free celebration as security operatives ensured maintenance of law and order. From Kefi, Suraj Abdullahi, NTA News.
Still on the celebrations, while most residents of the Federal Capital Territory were enjoying the two-day Eid al-Kabir holidays, others worked all throughout the festive period to keep essential services going. Adebola Brooklyn Sunday made this observation and filed a situation report.
The federal secretariat that houses most civil servants in the city is empty because workers are enjoying the Eid al-Kabir holiday.
Most of the roads in the metropolis can also feel the absence of the usual heavy flow of traffic. One of the major activities during the festive period is the convergence of Muslim faithful on the Eid prayer ground for the two rakat prayer. Security operatives and road traffic officers were on ground to ensure the maintenance of law and order.
And one of my responsibility and tax is that I should protect lives and property. And one of it is this one. So if these people were to remain here for the next day, I have a moral and a statutory duty to remain here and supervise these officers.
And our own role to play to make sure that there is a hitch-free movement of motorists, not only hitch-free, but to equally make sure that everybody reaches destination safely.
When NTA's crew visited the Federal Medical Center Jabi, Abuja, medical practitioners were on duty to attend to patients in case of any emergency.
We are happy providing these services because a part of us is an oath that we sworn to.
Just like myself, there are several media practitioners working to ensure that those on holiday are informed, entertained, and at the same time, educated.
It's the passion for the job that keeps us moving. We know that without information, we are going nowhere.
Observers say the dedication of these professionals who go the extra mile to ensure that the society at large enjoy the festive period underscore the need for employers of labor to reciprocate by paying them better remuneration. Adebola, Brooklyn Sunday, NTA News.
Most national holidays, as well as festive seasons, such as these Eid al-Fitr celebrations, has availed families and friends the opportunity to ease off work stress and bond with loved ones. Ngufan's Shaji was at some recreational centers within the FCT and filed this report.
The atmosphere here at the Mona Lisa Park is warm and welcoming. The weather seems relaxed, one in which you would expect that a park should be stacked up with people. But the situation seems a little bit different. Most of the seats and the swings, as you can see, are empty. This is because some of the people that we spoke with earlier said the economic situation seemed to have affected the turnout to the fun of the Eid al-Fitr.
In fact, since we've been experiencing festive period, we've never experienced such a very low turn-up like this.
However, at the Millennium Park, the turnout was quite impressive and the ambience reflected the mood of the celebration.
We're here to relax, to receive some fresh airs.
We're just here to unwind today because we've been working all this while and we just got some time out to just have fun with our family members.
To celebrate the sacrifice and also to be thankful for the gift of life and remain focused in worship.
At the kids' fun view, parents and their children were basking in the euphoria of the Salah while thanking God for his mercies on the nation and its people.
Are you having fun?
Yes.
Okay, what have you done?
I've done the dragon balloon. I've done the car. I've done so many things.
I think the Salah is a blessing.
Happy Salah.
In Abuja, Ufan Shaji, NTA News.
In other news, six more pilgrimage zonal offices will be established to add to the existing six for effective participation and operations of the Christian pilgrimage. Executive Secretary, Nigerian Christian Pilgrim Commission, NCPC, Tor Uja, announced this at the second Conference of Pilgrimage Leaders and Managers of Nigeria in Abuja. Lydia Basi has the report.
The six zones will be located at Lagos, Port Harcourt, Onitsha, Abuja, Kano and Gombe. Tor Uja, who said the NCPC is focused on strengthening and developing the cause of pilgrimage in Nigeria, enjoined Nigerians to change the perception of the world towards Nigeria by building the economy and putting into practice what they learn during pilgrimage.
I want the leaders of the church to rise up and join in building this country on concrete pillars, promoting values, creating direction, and building stability across all the regions of this country.
Participants at the conference commended the efforts of the NCPC at bringing pilgrimage leaders and managers in the country together towards rebranding Christian pilgrimage.
All our leaders and managers to be dedicated so that this work that is heavenly will not be aborted on the way.
I want to encourage us to utilize many of the things that we have gained in this conference because of the spiritual content.
And that will help me help my state spiritually and morally.
The last phase of 2016 pilgrimage begins 29th October and ends 22nd December. Lydia Basi, NTA News.
As the campaign on value reorientation through the Change Begins With Me initiative of the government gathers momentum, guests on NTA's Good Morning Nigeria have stressed the need to strengthen the nation's public institutions for the success of the campaign. Joy Uzo monitored the program and now reports.
Unlike in the past when patriotism, integrity and honesty was the norm, the craze to make quick money, fame and other hues has led to the loss of the nation's cultural norms and values. This unfortunate development was blamed on the leaders of the country who have failed to lead by example. The guest comprising Ike Naokoli, author of the book The Change Begins With Me, which was published before the present government took over power, and Nollywood Best Actor of the Year Daniel K. Daniel, are of the opinion that much as good parental upbringing contributes to molding strong moral character in individuals from the cradle, the example of leaders plays a strong role in sustaining such values. They, however, emphasize that individuals must also endeavor to make right decisions that would improve their image and that of the nation.
What we mean doing the right thing is not about self-righteous. It is about basic universal principles of honesty, integrity, hard work.
The entertainment industry has a big role to play because most young people, even elderly people, see entertainers as role models and try to, you know, sometimes we do something and then people think it's cool and, you know, they also want to emulate. And yes, that puts a lot of pressure on us to always do right. But again, it's still a personal thing.
Other guests on the program suggested reliance on the educational system by encouraging a reading culture among youths.
One of the ways that we can effectively engage youth is to actually give them a voice. And you give them a voice at the decision-making table, at the negotiating table. You recognize, help youth recognize that you're actually listening.
If I'm asked to a kind of proffer an idea on how we are going to go about this, I am going to say something like a sort of partnership. Change along with me.
They said for the Change Begins With Me drive of the federal government to succeed, there should be a working partnership between the government and the people, with each effectively doing its part. In Abuja, Joy Uzo, NTA News.
You can watch this news live online via the NTA mobile app, which you can download on your Android devices at the Google Play Store or at the Apple Store if you use devices with iOS. Still to come, Senate laments suspension of scheduled operations in Nigeria by some airlines. Details after this break.
When was it released? Yes. Much less this. And this. And this. And this. Reclaim our commonwealth, lend your support to the fight against corruption for a better Nigeria. Discover the liquid freshness of Center Fresh chewing gum that you feel. Others too. Center Fresh. Trust the freshness.
The family of a corn has been taken hostage by an evil looking creature.
The thing just show for night. You're being well,
My sister. I was there when it was happening in the news.
She suddenly brought back your family.
I'm a 10-foot up here. My lady, I run for cover.
I'm a 10. Thank you.
I'm a 10-foot against some jail capsules, tablets for adults, and suspension for the king. I'm a 10 that does not eat somebody, and I'm very easy to use.
I you are. Remember, I'm a 10-4 against crack pain to confirm the original.
And I get some gel capsules. I'm a 10. Say no to malaria. Yes to life.
What happened? It was a mosquito.
What's happening here?
Mama, mosquitoes.
I spray it, but the mosquitoes are dead. No longer, because I've got Neotain powder, which kills 100% mosquitoes. Neotain powder kills 100% mosquitoes.
Some say Africa's golden era is gone. Great African kings and queens built their dreams into empires stretching across the continent and beyond. But we say a new era is upon us. A new set of African kings and queens are on the rise, driven by the same wealth of character as the kings and queens before them. Building new empires of enterprise with the right partnership. So rise up wherever you are, you kings and queens of Africa. Embrace your full potential and be proud of your heritage. Heritage Bank, the timeless wealth partner.
Ace University Abuja offers world-class education, uninterrupted academic session, and promising degrees for a sustainable job. Ace University Abuja is affordable and delivers quality with experienced international staff, superb facilities, overseas external examiners, and a serene academic atmosphere. We offer quality and affordable education, and students are within easy reach of their parents here at Ace University Abuja. So learn to live at Ace University for a brighter future. For more information, visit our website at www.baseuniversity.edu.ng or call 081-3376-9657 or 081-3376-9658. Baze University Abuja. Learn to live.
Drivers Association hereby felicitate with all its members nationwide on the occasion of Eid al-Kabir. We wish to ask our members to continue to bear with the federal government in its resolve to reposition the country in the right direction. Also, we wish to implore our members to take extra precautions while using the road. They should note that since we started training our drivers, we have witnessed less road accidents. Once again, Barka da Salla, announcer Otumba Salmon Oladiti, JP, Chairman, Petroleum Tanker Drivers Association, NUPENG.
Glad to have you back on NTA Network News. The federal government has inaugurated a technical committee to draft a new national justice sector policy for Nigeria. Solicitor General of the Federation and Permanent Secretary, Federal Minister of Justice, Mr. Taiwo Abidogun, inaugurated the committee. Femi Okewo reports.
The national justice sector policy of any country is meant to define the relationship between the nation's prosecuting agencies, such as the police, the Attorney General's office, and the reformatory centers, such as the prisons. In Nigeria, a number of reforms had in the past been initiated for all these sectors. This committee, as part of its assignment, will therefore harmonize and integrate all these reforms. Solicitor General of the Federation, Mr. Taiwo Abidogun, who did the inauguration, said the policy would represent Nigeria's political philosophy with respect to justice delivery and provide a common direction for the sector.
It must be realized that the work of the committee is a necessary component of the overall agenda of this administration to promote respect for human rights and due process in both our domestic and international engagements.
The 16-member technical committee for the draft of the National Justice Sector Policy for Nigeria is headed by Professor Mohammed Tabiu, a professor of law.
Highly desirable initiative for Nigeria to have a justice policy that guides all of us, not just for one institution, not just for one level of government, but one that unites Nigerians.
The draft policy will be considered at a stakeholders forum in October for input before being presented for validation and adoption at the proposed National Summit on Administration of Justice to hold in November. In Abuja, Femi Okewu, NTA News.
From justice to the aviation sector, following the suspension of scheduled operations by some airlines in the country, regulators and operators in the aviation industry have appeared before the Senate Committee on Aviation to explain what the committee described as disturbing turn of events in the aviation sector. National Assembly correspondent Dennis Adegoloye reports.
What are the reasons behind that? We know the economy is in recession, but air transportation in Nigeria nowadays is no longer a luxury. It is a necessity, and it will aggravate the economic hardship people are facing if airlines continue to suspend their operations.
The operators in question are the Aero Contractors of Nigeria, currently under the administration of the Asset Management Corporation of Nigeria, AMCON, and First Nation Airways. Director General of the Nigerian Civil Aviation Authority, Captain Mukhtar Usman, and representatives of the airlines give reasons for the suspension.
Our first priority is to protect human beings, that is the safety aspect of it.
The 29th of July, we're taxiing into Lagos. One of the engines flamed out.
Our liabilities more or less exceeded whatever we made.
Unavailable foreign exchange resulting from the economic downturn, as well as the underutilization of the Central Bank of Nigeria bailout fund for the aviation industry, are also identified as causes of the lull in operations.
There hasn't been a bailout that is targeted at salvaging the airlines.
For every naira you sell a ticket, how much of it goes out as taxes and levies and things?
How much percent?
We put it at 40 cover.
40%. So how can anybody operate in such an environment?
The Senate Committee on Aviation is expected to further engage the Minister of Aviation, AMCON, and other relevant bodies on the matter. From the National Assembly, Dennis Adigunle, NTA News.
We have more on Salah festivities in Lagos as we join Abdullahi, who is there in our Lagos Network Center. Hello, Abdullahi. Barakat Salah.
Berka Nasella Kudu, thanks for joining us in Lagos. As it's typical at public holidays, the Lagos business district was devoid of its usual hustle and bustle as Lagosians joined the Muslim faithful to celebrate Eid al-Kabir. Tekla Wilke went round town to have a feel of the ambience.
This year's Eid al-Kabir celebration witnessed significant turnout of people at the various prayer grounds in Lagos.
The message is, let's try to be like Prophet Ibrahim. He submitted himself to Allah, and Allah raised his status. If we submit ourselves to Allah, Allah will raise our status, both in this one and the next world.
Thereafter, Muslim faithful switched gears to observe the festivity in style. While some observed the Salah festivity indoors, others opted for outdoor celebration.
Father, we are thank God that still alive.
The country big.
What do you person go do now? So we thank God.
A visit to some recreation centers in Lagos revealed that Muslim and non-Muslim embrace the holiday season with enthusiasm and excitement, as the holiday afforded them the opportunity to relax and unwind.
We are really, really enjoying the Salah. You know, it is for everybody, despite the fact that you are Christian or Muslim. So every one of us, we are one.
The lesson for the season is that we need to be steadfast, we need to remain firm with Allah, we need to be patient, and we need to tolerate one another.
As Lagos residents enjoy the frills and thrills of a Salah festivity, citizens were advised to maintain law and order during and after the Eid al-Kabir celebration.
So far, so far, we have not recorded any incident of accident or crash.
In Lagos, Fekla Wilkie, NTA News.
An elderly man has lost his life following an accidental fire outbreak on a residential building in Suru Lere, Lagos. Annie Daniels reports that the fire occurred at about 10 o'clock in the morning and was actually started by the deceased.
It was indeed a bleak Eid for residents of No. 5 Abori Shade Close, Lawans in Suru Lere, following a fire incident. According to eyewitness accounts, the fire started from an electric boiling ring, which was plugged by an 84-year-old man.
It was boiling water with the boiling ring. So then he went to sleep, and he had his daughter with him, who is married with two kids. But we don't know what happened, because they were boiling the water right inside their apartment. So we just saw smoke. So everybody rushed down.
The eyewitness said that prompt intervention of men of the Lagos State Fire Service prevented the inferno from affecting adjoining buildings.
The only road to this place is being blocked by the construction of that road. So they had difficulties in getting here, but at the end of the day, they tried their best. In fact, I was impressed.
As at the time of filing this report, neighbors were seen moving their belongings out of the building. Meanwhile, corpse of the deceased has been deposited at the Lagos State University Teaching Hospital mortuary. In Lagos, Annie Daniels, NTA News.
You're still on to NTA Network News. Kudu will return with more news from Abuja after a short timeout from here.
Glow is in the air. It's data. It's what you use every time you download music. It's what streams movies. It's what the banks use to check your account.
It's the very lifeblood of modern living. Data. And where does it all come from? According to industry sources, more and more of it came from here. They acknowledge that Glow is now the largest data network in Nigeria. With your own Glow One submarine cable linked seamlessly to tens of thousands of kilometers with your own fiber optic cable, Glow can provide huge data capacity anywhere at a more flexible and affordable price than anyone. It's simple. So you see, Glow is in the air. It's everywhere. Say hello to the Grandmaster.
Join Glow to jollificate with 8 times the value on every recharge, plus free data to give. Every recharge allows data and voice.
The largest data network, Glow, Grandmasters of Data.
This is the moment of truth. The moment... No. The reason you have been born. It's not the past. It's not the future. It is the now. You must not stand as man, but as a legion. And let me feel the roaring fire of determination and sacrifice. Sacrifice. Beating at one heart. This is our night. Because tonight is my...
Sausage, lunch.
This must be one of Mother Nature's greatest gifts. But there's something else it gives us. When we see such beauty, we want to share it with those we love. That's what LG wants you to see. Just what we see now, through our technology. LG OLED TV.
The Administrative Staff College of Nigeria, ASCON, is organizing a four-day national workshop on Financial Regulations and Fiscal Responsibility Act. The workshop is targeted at accountants, auditors, finance officers, stock verifiers, budget officers, planning officers, procurement officers, stores officers, treasurers, buzzers, administrative officers and others whose duties involve financial control and accountability in the MDAs on grade level 7 and above. Date, October 4th to 7th, 2016. Venue, ASCON Complex Topo Badagry. Fee, 75,000 Naira, excluding lodging and feeding. For inquiries, please contact Afolanyo, Workshop Director on 080-3318-2344 or Lawson, Workshop Coordinator on 070-3490-5536. Announcer, Director General, ASCON.
Nigerians. Suicide bombers are not spirits. They are not ghosts. They are human beings like you and me. They live amongst us. They are your neighbors. They are your friends today, but terrorists tomorrow. So you must know your neighbor now. Security begins with you and me. Know your neighbor. Be vigilant. Be security conscious. Report suspicious persons, objects, and movements to the police and other security agencies. The security of our nation is a duty for you and me.
If you see something, say something. Nigeria, unite against terrorism. This message is brought to you by the Federal Ministry of Information and Culture.
Thank you for remaining with RTA Network News. In other news now, experts urge exporters to ensure strict compliance and adherence to international best practices so that no Nigerian agro product is again rejected in the international market. Here's Cheslin Okie with details on business news.
Baraka Dosala, glad to have you join us on business news. Latest data from the United Nations Conference on Trade and Development indicates that Nigeria and other African countries lose an estimated $23 billion in earnings yearly due to continued rejection. They say owing to the policy thrust of the Muhammadu Buhari administration to give maximum attention to non-oil sector development, there is the need to enlighten exporters of agricultural products on the importance of packaging and quality control in international commodity transactions.
It has to go through this process of assaying, which is a technical way of knowing that it is qualitative. One, it is free from impurities. Second, the consumption, you can consume it because it has no some insecticides that misapplication of such. All these will be regulated and be ensured by the commodity exchange. So you can have other regulatory bodies, but when it comes to commodities, you have to have a functional commodity exchange.
For every country, they have their standards that a product must meet before consumption. They have very strong consumer regime and consumer regulations.
For the first time ever in Nigeria, we, the small and medium scale level, we have been called upon by government to participate in the interministerial committee of the zero reject program of government. We must give goods according to the qualities, the intermarket requirement and everything.
Well, it is hoped that if given the desired attention, Nigerian products will begin to receive international recognition and acceptance. That wraps up this segment. I am Chiazala Mekie. Do stay tuned for the rest of the news.
Thank you, Chiazala. The Nigerian Navy has announced that the Nigerian Navy ship, NNS Okpabara, has been designated to participate in a sea exercise scheduled to take place between the 13th and 16th of this month on the Nigerian waters. A statement by the Director of Information, Nigerian Navy, Commodore Christian Odogu, explained that two French warships, HPD Digsmond and FF Codwin, will lead the French Maritime Initiative under the Exercise Nemo series, tagged Exercise Nemo 16.5, with the theme Maritime Structure on Securitization. The exercise is geared towards sharpening skills in anti-piracy and anti-illegal fishing activities. The statement adds that the exercise seeks to strengthen a 2013 agreement between the Economic Community of Central African States and the Economic Community of West African States to fight piracy in the Gulf of Guinea. The vessels will carry out several exercises, including a simulated attack on an oil tanker, which is expected to be tracked by Nigeria's Maritime Domain Awareness Capability Systems. The quest for solutions and strategies in combating crimes in the society has continued to be a joint responsibility of all security stakeholders. Against this background, the Cross River State Police Command has inaugurated an Eminent People's Forum for Police Preventive and Proactive Roles in the state. Udwak Etim has the report.
The meeting, which attracted people of different segments of the society, including the state government officials, traditional rulers, retired and serving police officers, among others, was to interact and bring out strategies for fighting crimes and criminalities in the society. The Cross River State Commissioner of Police, Jimo Oziobe, who inaugurated the forum on behalf of the Inspector General of Police, Ibrahim Idris, said, "The Eminent People Forum is to collaborate with other police committee and security agencies for effective policing." He charged the stakeholders to hold regular security meetings in their respective domains to ensure that people live in peace.
The main objective of the forum is to bring police and police activities near to the community, to your doorstep. You are here today. If anything is happening within your community, We are soliciting assistance to assist us pass information to members of the community, of your community.
Secretary to the State Government, Tina Agbo, called on the traditional rulers and other stakeholders to support the police force in order to discharge its duties effectively. Etubom Bob Duke, who represented the Obong of Calabar, Edidemekpo Konobasio II V, solicited the support of the police to arrest and persecute any masquerade walking around the streets of Calabar begging for money, noting that there is a season and event warranting the appearance of masquerade in Calabar. The interactive session with the security stakeholders presented a platform for them to express their views and give useful security strategies for fighting crimes in the states. In Calabar, Udwak Etem, NTA News.
From Calabar to Port Harcourt, where Muslim leaders in River State pay homage to Governor Yemi Osinwike, this and more with Mina Akwabasi in our Port Harcourt Network Center. Mina, you're on.
Thank you, Mohammed. Welcome to Port Harcourt. River State Governor Yemi Osinwike has charged the Muslim community in the state to reflect on the economic challenges facing the nation and pray for the peace and sustainability of Nigeria. The governor gave the charge when a delegation from the Muslim community paid him a Salah homage at the government house, Port Harcourt. Chidebere Onya has the report.
It has become a tradition that every Salah celebration, Muslim community in the state pays a visit to the governor in demonstration of their obedience and support for the administration. Governor Wike enjoined everyone to work towards uniting the nation, irrespective of the religion.
Let us most importantly use this period to think about our country, to pray for our nation. It's key. It does not matter the political party you belong to. Our country is our country.
Leader of the delegation, Alhaji Kasim Okachi, while thanking the governor for identifying and celebrating with the Muslim community in the state, appreciated him for sponsoring their members to Hajj. Imam Malik Yahaya prayed for the state, peace, and sustainability of the nation. In Port Harcourt, Chidiebere Onye, NTA News.
The Nigerian Navy Basic Training School, ONE, has organized a farewell parade for the outgoing commandant, Commodore Peter Onaji. Karina Igonikol has more.
The Nigerian Navy Training School, ONNEH, has the responsibility of conducting leadership and management courses for senior ratings in addition to providing basic training for all new entrants into the ratings cadre. The outgoing commandant, Commodore Peter Onaji, while delivering his speech, noted that he enjoyed a good working relationship with his officers and recorded many achievements in areas of infrastructure and well-equipped facilities for training in the command. Commodore Onaji also declared that during his tenure, said 24 of the trainees successfully completed their course.
For the first time, the Nigerian Navy signed a memorandum of understanding with the University of Port Harcourt to award academic diploma certificates. I'm leaving without losing any of my staff.
He affirmed the Navy's commitment to securing the Niger Delta region against sea pirates and oil bunkers. There was a farewell parade by command officers. In ONNEH, Karina Igodiko, NTA News.
That's it from Port Harcourt. It's back to you, Mohammed.
Thank you, Mina. A mild earth tremor was recorded in some communities within Jaba local government area of Kaduna State. Zigwe Ayubagwani reports that apart from cracks on the few houses, there was no major devastation recorded and no loss of lives.
On reaching White Town, the affected areas, people were seen going about their normal businesses, and no visible effect of the earth tremor was observed. When NTA News contacted the district head of FADA, Stephen Nyamsani, on the incidents, he explained that the earth tremor started Sunday morning to the early hours of Monday morning, affecting six districts. He said apart from minor cracks on some buildings, no devastating effect, and therefore urged people not to panic.
There wasn't any records of death, massive destructions of houses as it was painted.
NTA News visited a few of the affected houses and found out that, apart from the cracks and some damaged ceilings, no casualties were recorded. Already, some geographers are there conducting investigations to ascertain the cause of the tremor. In Kapancha, Zigwe Ayubagwani, NTA News.
Still on the environment, governments around the world have again been called upon to pay attention to environmental reports and evolve policies to protect the environment for improved socio-economic development. This was at the opening of the meeting of the Working Group on Environment Auditing of the Africa Organization of Supreme Audit Institutions, holding in Abuja. Leah Katumba Watunde reports that experts expressed concern on the survival of the Lake Chad.
Water, they say, is life. The depletion of Lake Chad, attributed to climate change, is in no small measure affecting survival and habitation around the water body. The environment is said to be a common heritage without which no life is possible. Therefore, audit on Lake Chad has thrown open dire effects of the drying up of the water body on the environment and its impact on survival.
The environment is not just for us, it's for posterity, it's for the future, it's for our children and for our grandchildren.
What do people live from? They live from fish, agriculture, and all this needs water. Fishing, agriculture need water. And if you don't have fish, if you don't have agriculture, then people will be forced to move into big cities. Then you will have conflicts because of migrations maybe.
Cooperative Environmental Audit Project on River Niger is also in the offing.
There's a lot of navigation activities, so it's very relevant and very important, even in terms of agriculture. So we looked at it and said we don't want to stay back and wait and watch and see what happened to Lake Chad, happened also to River Niger.
Declaring the meeting open, Minister of Environment, represented by Bankole Phillips, called for sustainable environment management in line with the agreement reached at the Paris Conference on Climate Change, as well as the Sustainable Development Goals.
Land degradation, desertification, deforestation, loss of biodiversity, flooding, and other environmental disasters are of great concern that affects our own very life.
The reports of the Auditor General for the Federation should be taken seriously so that corrections will be met. For many years, the report of the Auditor General has not been considered.
The meeting, which is the sixth since inception, is themed Working Together for a Sustainable Environment in Africa and brings together audit institutions on the continent to engage in a week-long dialogue on environmental issues. In Abuja, Lekatung Baba Tunde, NTA News.
Up ahead, global tidbits, sports, and Wednesday's weather forecast. Don't go away.
Eat fish at least twice a week, including a portion of oily fish. Fish like mackerel, sardine, fresh tuna, salmon, and catfish are a source of omega-3 fats, which can help protect the heart against diseases. But remember, pregnant women or breastfeeding mothers shouldn't take more than 2 portions of oily fish a week.
And the jam is pumping. Look at the crowd is jumping.
Jump up and jam and push up your hand. You know, say me fans, they plenty like sand. Jump up and dance, make them understand. Say me in a jam, could I never be contraband?
No, matter what life throws at me, I cannot feel it constantly.
All of my fans, they're invited. DJ, make my day.
The production, distribution, and sale of counterfeit and fake drugs is a corrupt practice and a crime against humanity. This has informed several measures and strategies to combat fake drugs, including introduction of anti-counterfeiting cutting-edge technologies to detect fake drugs on the spot. These technologies are being deployed to all the states across the Federation, as well as the internally displaced people's camps. The President, Muhammadu Buhari, and his team are committed to this fight.
The federal government of Nigeria, in line with its anti-corruption agenda and posture, will fight a total war against fake drugs and other unwholesome regulated products in order to ensure that Nigerians remain healthy and well.
Lend your support and join NAFDAC to rid the country of fake drugs and unwholesome regulated products. NAFDAC, safeguarding the health of the nation.
This is NTA Network News. Now, stories from the international scene. Zimbabwe police reimposes protest ban a week after a high court suspended the ban. German policemen detained 3 Syrian men suspected to be Islamic State militants, likely to launch an attack. For more on Global Tidbits, let's join Chimdima Ndubisi.
Zambia's President Edgar Lungu, whose re-election was challenged by his rival from the main opposition party, has been sworn in. His inauguration speech centered on unity and vow to fight corruption. And East African leaders are in Somalia for the regional body summit. This is the first time Somalia, a country engrossed in war for decades, is hosting the extraordinary summit after 30 years of its existence. The meeting is focusing on Somalia and South Sudan's security situation. In the meantime, the hope of resolving the rising political tension in Democratic Republic of Congo is dashed as the only opposition party involved in the African Union-led talks pulled out. It is alleged that the president, Joseph Kabila, is blocking the electoral process in order to extend his tenure. Elsewhere in Syria, the ceasefire deal brokered by the United States and Russia is holding, with no civilian deaths recorded on this first day. But there are reports of minor violations in some areas. However, the United Nations officials are requesting for a guarantee of peace before they embark on delivering aid to areas surrounded by government troops. That's Global Tidbits. Chimdema Ndubisi, NTA News.
And in sports, Nigeria's junior cricket team tops 8 Nation Division 2 qualifying series in South Africa. And Maria Sharapova keeps a date with the Court of Arbitration on Sports in October. Amanzi Marcos has more on Sports Update.
Nigeria's
Nigeria's under-19 men's cricket team moved another step closer to sealing qualification to Division 1 category for the 2018 Cricket World Cup. The Junior Greens recorded a third impressive win as Captain Okpe Sylvester produced a captain's performance to hunt Nigeria 209 runs all out in 49 overs against Sierra Leone on Monday after consecutive victories over Zambia and Rwanda to top the group. Next for Nigeria in the 8 Nation Division 2 qualifying series is the match against Botswana on Thursday in Johannesburg, South Africa. Meanwhile, Nigeria's contingent recorded 2 gold medals on day 6 of the Rio 2016 Paralympics to place 10th with 6 gold, 2 silver and 1 bronze medal to be reckoned the best African country in the games so far. The Chinese won 26 more medals on Monday to extend their commanding lead to 50 gold, 40 silver and 28 bronze medals with a total of 118 medals. Great Britain and Northern Ireland have a total of 63 medals, while hosts Brazil maintained their fifth position with 9 gold, 17 silver and 9 bronze medals. The group phase of the UEFA Champions League continues on Wednesday with 8 matches in groups E to H. Club Brugge takes on Leicester City in Group G, while Italian champions Juventus host Sevilla with Lyon at home against Dinamo Zagreb.
Hello and welcome to the weather forecast. I am Olichukwu Anuku. We observed some weather systems from the Chad Republic and we expect it to move zonally, bringing about weather activities around the northeastern part of the country, most part of the extreme north and the central cities, including Abuja and the southern cities. But later in the afternoon, isolated cases of rain showers are not unlikely over the northeast, parts of the high grounds on the central cities and the southern cities. I leave you with temperature forecast. Thank you for watching and bye for now.
To end network news, remember you can access all our stories and much more when you log on to our website, www.nta.ng. And that concludes NTA network news for tonight. Thank you for watching. Good night.